Owatonna High School boys tennis coach Kurt Matichak, and it seems to me, Kurt, that the only thing that keeps you guys from winning matches is Mother Nature.
Yeah, I think that's been our toughest competition so far, Roy. We've really jumped out to a fantastic start, 6-0 on the season.
And what has been the reason for it?
You know, I think part of it has to do with just returning a bunch of singles players from last year's team. We have all four singles players back, and that has just really built some continuity into the program. So very helpful. And then our doubles team of Michael Duer and Tim Starman are our two returning doubles players playing number one doubles. They've done a fantastic job as well as filling in at that number one spot. Eden Morozak, Ethan Schultz, Noah Velasquez, and Derek Theta have been doing the yeoman's work up there at the single spots and all having very successful starts of the season.
Have you run more or less with the same lineup then in each match too?
Roy, we've been pretty consistent. And actually, Eden Morozak missed a match for us at number one singles. Everybody else moved up that day. Michael Duer and Tim Starman have played every match at number one doubles, as has Dan Keller and Mark Hansen, who are undefeated at number two doubles this season. At number three doubles, we've had a kind of a platoon. We've had Reed Tucker, Cody Bussert, and Jack Redmond all filling in at those spots. And we've really had some success down there, so it's been fun to watch.
Now, as far as the Big Nine Conference goes, who are the besides yourselves, who are the strong teams in the conference that loom on the schedule?
Well, you know, Roy, to be honest with you, I said at the beginning of the season, I still think we're going to be one of those teams fighting for, you know, the number four or five position in the Big Nine. Rochester Mayo was to be the team to beat, but within the last 2 weeks, it looks like Rochester Century is going to be that team. They actually picked up a new player, Jesse Aney, who is a female, who is now their number one singles player. She is back from Florida. She was actually trying out for the pro circuit, and she's back playing number one singles for Century, and they now look like the team to beat.
And she's top 10 rated in the state individually.
She is. And not only that, I believe some of the kids are saying she actually is number two or three in the nation for her age group on the girls' side. And it is going to be fun to watch her, but I'm sure some of the boys are thinking otherwise at this point.
Yeah, top 10 rated in the boys' standings is Jessica Aney, the female player for Rochester Century. So that's pretty amazing. And you see them next week on the road, don't you?
We do. We get an opportunity to see them. You know, they're a better team than us. We would have to play very well, but we're always excited about playing those top 10 teams, and hopefully we'll play our best tennis that day.
Who do you, are you at a tournament tomorrow in Lakeville, Saturday in Lakeville?
We are, right. We are. We will actually face Lakeville South in the first round of an 8-team tournament up there. Edina being there, White Bear Lake, Robbinsdale Armstrong, Mounds Park Academy, Chanhassen, ourself, and Austin. We will face the winner or loser of the Mound Park Chanhassen match. So we're guaranteed three matches tomorrow, and we're really excited about going to play some teams other than those in the Big Nine.
All right, very nice. Kurt Matichak, Owatonna High School boys tennis, off to a great start, unbeaten on the season, but certainly some very tough matches upcoming. Good luck to you and the guys, Kurt.
Thanks, Roy.
Owatonna boys tennis on KRFO.